Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Waharacha Kodash, Barakatham. I want to give double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who rule well, who taught me this truth, and most definitely labor in his word. I also want to give a sincere peace, blessing, salutations to all you Akim across the four corners of the globe that are out here pushing this gospel, which is the good news. And our truthfulness and sincerity. You so-called Negroes, you so-called Latinos / Hispanics, you so-called Native Americans / Seminole Indians, as well as you Israelite foreigners that have been scattered across the four corners of the globe that may look like one of the other 17 heathen nations, but if your bloodline goes back to the seed of a so-called Negro, a so-called Latino / Hispanic, a so-called Native American / Seminole Indian, then you are in fact and indeed an Israelite. If you can perceive it through the spirit. As well as I want to give peace and blessings to the Akwaf, which are the sisters who believe upon the name of the Lord Yahweh in the name of his son Yahushai. And I want to give peace and blessings to the children that believe upon the name of the Lord Yahweh in the name of his son Yahushai. It's your brother Karatazah, and I'm back with another video epistle. Lord willing, it's edifying to those of you who may come across it. Okay, and today's lesson comes from the King James Bible Online verse of the day for Friday, October 15th, 2021, the year of hastening the day of our Lord Yahushai. All right, as deemed by the Apostle Tahar of Great Millstone, which he received all through the Rakach Hadash, which is the Holy Spirit. Okay, and it comes from the book of Psalms, chapter 51 and verse 11, and it reads, All the Shalach Naya. Malapinyaka Waraka Kwadashka Al Dalakwak Mamanaya. All right. And what I said was this here, cast me not away from thy presence and take not thy Holy Spirit from me, which I said it in the Paleo Hebrew, all right, which I learned years ago. It was already one of my favorite scriptures, all right. And then one day I seen it written out in a Great Millstone documentary, all right? And I literally pray this every day, all right? Every morning when I wake up, all tashalach naya malapinyaka raraka kuradashka al talakwek mama naya yabaraka yahawa wayashamarka yar yahawa panya wa or yakaw wayakhanka yashay yahawa panya wa or yakaw wayashimilka shalom, all right? Hey, the Lord Yahweh keep thee and bless thee. The Lord Yahweh make thy face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord Yahweh lift up thy countenance upon thee and give thee peace. All right. Hey, these are prayers that we can say in the Paleo Hebrew. All right. That Lord willing, the Heavenly Father hears us. All right. But the basis of this lesson is the scripture here, cast me not away from thy presence and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Because once the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, takes his Holy Spirit from you, if you have received the gift of faith, all right, according to Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 8, all right, you're done for, you're through, all right. The Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, it's not dealing with you anymore, okay? And I got some precepts written down, all right? And like I said, Lord willing, this lesson is going to be edifying. It's not that long, all right? So I'm going to go straight to the point. I have an example of the Lord taking this Holy Spirit away, all right, from an individual, which we have many examples. But I'm going to go here to the book. So like here, we're going to go here to the book of 1 Samuel, all right, chapter 16, all right, and we're just going to go straight to the point, all right, and it reads, But the Spirit of the Lord Yahweh departed from Saul, and an evil spirit from the Lord Yahweh troubled him, all right, this is why King David, all right, In the KJV Bible verse of the day in the book of Psalms, he wrote this he sung this prayer, all right, Cast me not away from thy presence. Oh, and this, I gotta highlight this in this device. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Because even King David knew, of course, that the Heavenly Father Yahweh Shemel Shai took the spirit from Saul, because Saul was throwing javelins at him. All right, Saul became jealous of King David. All right, and because the Lord had took the spirit from him. Why? Because he disobeyed the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shemiah Shai. All right? It goes to tell us in the previous chapter, in 1 Samuel chapter 15. Let's just go here. I got certain points highlighted. Here's the point. And the Lord Yahweh sent thee on a journey and said, go and utterly destroy the sinners, the Amalekites, and fight against them until they be consumed. All right. And he said, and he told him to destroy everything and not to leave anything, not goats or nothing. All right. But let's read here in verse 23, for by Saul not doing that, the Lord took his spirit from him. All right. For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry, because thou hast rejected the word of the Lord. He also rejected thee from being king. Okay? So Khan. And then in verse 16, the Lord took his spirit from him. All right? Hey, that's why we have to pray constantly that the Lord continues to sup with us and doesn't take his Holy Spirit from us. Because once he takes his Holy Spirit from you, then you're through. All right? Let's go here. This is the book of St. John. All right? Chapter 14. And we're going to grab we'll read verses 15 through 18, okay? And it reads, if ye love me, keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive. All right? Hey, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but ye know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be with you. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. All right. Hey, what does it say in verse 17? Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, only the elect can receive, the hopeful elect can receive the Spirit of truth. All right. Because like the scripture says, many are called, few are chosen. All right. You can, do like I just recently, because there's been a lot of things going on within the church that I'm a part of, which is Great Millstone. All right. There's been a lot of things going on. All right. Hey, and you got guys going off doing their own thing. All right. Hey, so you could be in this thing for 30 plus years. All right. And throw it all away in one day, man. All right. And you don't want to, we don't want to do that. I got to throw myself in there first and foremost. Okay. Because the Lord, Yahweh Shemar Shai, will take the spirit from you. All right. If you playing with Yahweh Shai's money, all right, he gave 1, 5 talents. He gave 1, 2, and he gave another 1. All right. Whatever many talents you were given, if you don't flip those talents, all right, hey, Yahweh Shai will take that spirit from you, and he's going to come and destroy you, all right? Especially those of us in the know, hey, we'll get beaten with many stripes, all right, if the Heavenly Father not dealing with us, all right? So with that, let's grab one more scripture, and you know what? We'll close out with this scripture right here. This is going to be the book of Wisdom of Solomon in the Apocrypha. Let me see here. Yeah, Wisdom of Solomon. We'll start at Wisdom of Solomon chapter 1. Salakia, we'll start at verse 1. Love righteousness, ye that be judges of the earth. Think of the Lord with a good heart, meaning your mind, and in simplicity of heart, seek him. All right. Hey, the Lord is looking for those of a contrite heart. All right. and a broken spirit, roughly paraphrasing, all right? Verse 2, for he will be found of them that tempt him not, and show of himself unto such as do not distrust him. For forward thoughts separate from the Most High Yahweh and his power. When it is tried, reproveth the unwise. For into a malicious soul wisdom shall not enter, nor dwell in the body that is subject unto sin. And we just got that from King Saul, all right? When the Lord took his spirit from him, all right? For the Holy Spirit of discipline will flee deceit and remove from thoughts that are without understanding and will not abide when unrighteousness come in, all right? Hey, and Saul, he leaned onto his own understanding, all right? Hey, what does the scripture say? Trust in, roughly paraphrasing, trust in the Lord Yahweh with all thy heart, man. Lean not onto thy own understanding, all right? So with that, you know what? Lord willing, this video was edifying to those of you who may come across it. Hey, Psalms 51 and 11, man. Cast me not away from thy presence and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. So with that, I want to say, Kol HaLoyim La, Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Wahar HaKodash Barak Tum. Once again, I want to give double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone who taught me this truth and who labor in this word. And once again, I want to give a sincere peace, blessings, and salutations to all of you Akim across the four corners of the globe that are out here pushing this gospel, which is the good news. So with that, I want to say a ball, 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 and shalom.